Hi, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today, me and the Power BI Luchador are going to be going over analysis services versus Power BI Premium Gen 2. Who's going to come out the victor? Stay tuned! All right, before we get too far into analysis services versus Power BI Premium Gen 2, I thought it was important to level set and make sure people really understood why we'd be talking about this, right? So analysis services, or the tabular engine, is at the heart of the Power BI Premium Gen 2 offering. In fact, it's at the heart of the Power BI service. This tabular engine is the same engine that runs in Power BI Desktop, runs in Excel. It's the exact same in all of these spaces, right? So think of analysis services like the engine that powers the car that is Power BI. Now, Power BI Premium Gen 2 comes with a lot of additional features that analysis services doesn't have. And we're going to be diving into some of those big differences now. All right, when it comes to analysis services versus Power BI Premium Gen 2, there are a handful of features that analysis services has on lock that Power BI Gen 2 does not have yet. Number one, scale out capabilities. The ability to scale out your S1s out to 8 so that you handle all the needs of people as they're coming in, that is unparalleled. And the add in the ability to scale up to an S9 if I needed to, whoo! Power BI Luchador, you got your work cut out for you, showing me that you're going to be able to handle this type of thing inside of Power BI Premium Gen 2. Number two, metadata translations. This is something that you just straight up can't do inside of Power BI right now. What this does is it allows you to have one model, and you can have translations in so that, you know, people in France see French, people in Germany see German. That's something that analysis services can do, but Power BI Premium Gen 2 cannot. Number three, object level security. Object level security is when you need to secure someone so that someone can't even see a table exists inside your model. That's something that analysis services allows you to do, but it's something that you cannot do inside of Power BI Premium Gen 2. And then the final one that you can't do is perspectives. Perspectives is something that you cannot do. Right, perspectives, they crossed that off in August. All right, well, Power BI Luchador, you got your work cut out for you, showing me all the other features and why it would make up for the loss of these, why I'd switch over to Power BI Gen 2. Woo, all right, brother. Those are some measly advantages of working inside of analysis services. You cannot top what we have out in Power BI Premium Gen 2. I want to run through the list of all of the features, and then I'm going to get into the deal breaker. I'm going to drop the atomic elbow down on your analysis services, and I'm going to show you why you, everyone needs to be running with Power BI Premium Gen 2. All right, number one, everyone knows this one. This has been since the get-go of Power BI Premium, is the ability to have unlimited Power BI consumption by your users. No longer are you constrained by Power BI Pro licenses. You buy Premium, you can distribute to anyone inside your organization. Heck, if you turn on Exposed to Web, you could share that outside your organization. So that's been the foundation that's always been out there. Number two, and this is the big one. This is something that you've never been able to do before. This is the power that you've never ever had access to before, and that's the multi-model memory management. We're gonna get more into that because that is the ultimate finisher when it comes to Power BI Premium Gen 2. Of course, we've got our paginated reports, we've got our data flows, we've got our AI workloads. All of these things will help drive your analytics to that next level. Woo! So excited about those things. But those are videos in and of themselves. You have your pre-aggregated tables. You want to know about pre-aggregated tables? You gotta hone in and talk with my brother, Phil Seamark, he's the master of the pre-aggregated tables. You look at composite models. This is what everyone's been waiting for, is that composite model, that direct connection to multiple models inside one report, creating your own custom visuals, custom consumption. It's going to be out of this world. And then the automated incremental refreshes inside the Power BI Premium Service, just something you can't do inside of analysis services. Big thing there is also your bring your own key. That is out of this world. Great. And then the piece de la resistance is the brand new Power BI Premium Gen 2 scale out capabilities, so that you can always be providing the best experience for your end users with dynamic budgeting and the ability to create a chargeback framework inside your company. That's something that is so easy inside the Power BI framework that is exclusive to Power BI Premium Gen 2. But let's get into that dynamic memory management. Let's talk about the finishing punch. Yo, you chump, let's get over here. You show me. How does analysis services handle memory management? Boom. Yeah, sure. I can describe analysis services memory management. So when you buy a block of memory in analysis services, you get, you know, depending upon the capacity you get, let's say you get 100 gigabytes of memory, like in an S4, right? 70% of that could be used to house compressed data that you load into your model, and then users access, you'll need to allow at least 15% capacity for users to go in and access that information, have that information be decompressed and shown to users in visuals. And then you also want to have a 15% buffer to allow for data refreshes of individual tables inside the model. If you get anything above that that threshold, that 70% threshold, that's at the point in time where you need to look at scaling up, going to composite tables, or doing something else to either like shrink down your model. Luchador, explain to me why dynamic memory management is such an advantage over analysis services. Come on, bring it on. That's cute. I know that's how in analysis services you manage your memory. You go over the memory and you crash. You crash and burn and you die. That's what happens inside analysis services. Your only option when you need more than the memory you bought is you buy more analysis services. Well, here is the functionality that Power BI Premium Gen 2 finishes off analysis services with. And this has been something that has been inside the Power BI service since its inception, is Power BI Premium was able to do this dynamic memory management, so that if you bought 100 gigabytes of space, you could actually not be capped and throttled like you are inside of analysis services with just 70 gigs of data, but you could actually legitimately deploy 200, maybe even 300 gigs of data, you know, twice, 2 to 3 times, maybe even possibly 4 times the amount of models out inside of Power BI Premium. That was something you could already do that you didn't even know it. You didn't know you had access to this. But let me tell you about the death knell to analysis services that Power BI Premium Gen 2 offers. It is this unbelievable additional ability to get up to from 8 to 12 models out inside that existing premium service. It is unbelievable. Add in that ability to scale up, and you have the capacity where you're no longer constrained by memory. Memory management is almost a thing of the past. As long as your model's underneath the sides of your capacity, you can continue to deploy those out there as long as you have enough processors through either your existing premium capacity or your scale-up abilities to manage all everything that you're going to be going on inside there. So gone are the days of really getting worked up and worried about memory management. Now you're just going to be out. You're going to be running. You're going to be using a super, 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 super fast framework, and you're going to be loving it. What do you got to say to that? Okay. Hang on a second here. Before we get any further, and I mean, that is incredible. But how are you going to talk about, how are you going to top AAS's other advantages? Like the maturity of the platform, the advanced logging that it has, the easy integration with GitHub, how you can drive everything through DevOps, and your ability to, you know, build out and have many environments. That's something that Analysis Services has. How the heck do you do that with Power BI Premium? I'm turning that one back on you, Luchador. There's my pile driver. AAS other advantages. Oh, that's pretty cute. I understand you're all about Analysis Services and the legacy. Oh, boom! Power BI Premium per user Gen 2 tabular editor. GitHub integration, maturity of the framework, all of that is, it's all been built on the exact same framework that you're running Analysis Services in, that you have at your disposal for management. It's the ability to use modern tools and legacy tools to work and operate in your platform. This is something that just cannot be undersold or understated. What you can do inside of Power BI Premium Gen 2 is only additive. You are losing nothing when it comes to your existing frameworks for managing your models, managing your deployments. All you do is win, as one of my favorite performers say. All you do is win with Power BI Premium Gen 2. Woo! Wow, what an amazing battle between the Power BI Luchador and the analytics engineer. Those two really threw down. That was an impressive lineup. I think it's clear that the Power BI Luchador and Premium Gen 2 cleaned up against Analysis Services and the analytics engineer. There's no way that other guy in that gray t-shirt was able to stand up against the Luchador. So it's clear the recommendation going forward, if you're doing analytics work, 98% of you are going to be working on converting your AAS deployments out into Power BI Premium Gen 2. That's live today. You can go out there, just flip that switch, take advantage of that. The only reason you might not do that today is if you have object level security or if you need to have native translations. That is the real niche that you're talking about. Otherwise, you're going to be using Power BI Premium Gen 2, and you're going to be using the Power BI Premium PPU licenses for your dev and QA environments, and totally avoiding that cost. That is a killer combo when it comes to driving analytics in a modern framework at scale in global enterprises. There's no better solution. All right, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really had a great time making it. Make sure you hit that thumbs up, like, subscribe to the channel. Do that good stuff. It really helps support all the work that I'm doing. Thank you guys very much. Oh, head over to KratosBI.com. Buy me a coffee if you like this stuff. All the funds and proceeds go to help support the channel. You do, and I'll send you some I Love Power BI stickers, magnets, all that good stuff. Thank you guys very much. Peace. Wait, peace, wait, peace, wait, peace. How am I getting this wrong? Peace. There it is. Ha.